Hello and welcome to a new video of About Koi. And in this video, I want to discuss the body posture with you. So we are going to discuss key things to look at when you select a good body posture on a koi. And it is important to know that the body posture is really important for the growth rate, potential for the future, and how large a koi can reach. It is considered as one of the key factors for a high quality koi as well. And especially when a koi is like 1, 2, or 3 years old, it is important that you also consider body posture if you select a koi for your own pound. So a good body posture is key for a magnificent and elegant look when a koi becomes larger. And in this video, as you can see, I'm going to use 2 Chagoi and a Misuo Ogon to discuss this topic with you. We will cover all the basic concepts, what you have to look for regarding body posture if you want to select a koi. And the topics that I will cover in this video are the backbone of a koi, like the width of the shoulders, belly proportions, the tail area or the ozutsu, the pectoral fins, the head proportions and the mouth, and many other side key aspects that you take into account regarding the body posture. Body aspect 1 that I want to cover is the strong backbone. And the backbone is also called the jitai if you translate it to Japanese. And what the backbone is basically the area that starts just after the head until the highest point of the body. So it's actually the V shape, like this area which you can see. And what this area tells is how much mass a koi still can gain. So how much muscle and weight a koi can still gain in the next couple of months or years even. So what is important is that you can still see the backbone a little bit laying above the surface of the body. So it is typical that you can see like a V shape there. So, and when we talk about this backbone area, it is important to know that a koi grows from like the bottom upwards to the top. So that's why I call it the V-shape. At this moment, the back of the koi is like this. But what happens is when the koi grows, this will happen. So the shoulders will come up. And especially when you can still see this backbone visible, like above the surface, that especially well tells and explains that more mass can be gained in that area. For example, if that area would be really flat already, well, it basically tells there's not really enough space in the bone structure that more mass can be gained. And hence, typically that koi well won't have a really broad shoulder. So these Chagoi both have quite a good backbone visible. You don't want the backbone or the jitai or however you want to call it to be laying too much above the surface. So it needs to be in proportions, of course. And having said that, I truly believe that it is really about the proportions. So it's not as simple as just getting the best koi out of the boil with the best backbone. So for example, if you would like to select a Chagoi and you have 10 Chagoi in the bowl, then it's not the only aspect that you look for. You have to consider all aspects, of course, also color. But body is really the first thing you have to look for, if you ask me, especially for a one colored koi. So that about the backbone. The second item I would like to discuss is the width of the body. And I'm going to explain that using both Chagois again. The widest part of the body should be like just after the gills and the first pectoral fins, the both pectoral fins. So about this should be like the widest point of the body. And what you want is that it is like as torpedo looking towards the tail as possible. So you want it to be like quite a straight body line with the widest part in this area. So you don't want that this part is super wide and then here it is again super narrow. That's of course not a good body posture, and you can see that a little bit on the Mizuo Ogum. Still, the body is not that bad. I really did my best to find some different body structures, different bone structures on koi. But the Mizuo Ogum, you can see that the widest part is almost where the dorsal fin starts. So it's a little bit too far towards the middle of the koi. It's not too bad, it's still okay-ish. So this is a little bit the pigeon type of body structure. So it seems to be a little bit fatter in this area, and then yeah, it gets narrow before the tail actually starts. And for that reason, we call this a little bit of the shorter body conformation. And like I said already, it's not super bad on this Mizuo Ogum. It's still quite okay-ish, but it's just not the best body. The Chagoyev have both a better bone structure than this Mizuo Ogum. And I think that's also a little bit more genetics, of course. Most one-colored koi have better body postures, but it doesn't say everything. So that about the width of the shoulders, the width of the body overall. The third item that I want to discuss, and I'm going to use the Mizuo Ogum for this one, is the belly. And what you typically want, especially on a young koi, is that the belly is like flat. It should be rather more like having muscles instead of a belly. And what you really don't want is what this Mizuo Ogum has a little bit, it's not that bad to be honest, is that you can see that there is a belly. It's a little bit more round belly visible in this area. You want it as torpedo looking as possible, so as straight as possible. Also, the Chagoyev have it a little bit, but this is really, really not considered as bad to say it like that. The Mizuo Ogum has the worst body comparing these three koi, and you probably can see that. You can really see the belly well, a little bit too much in my opinion. So what you can see on this koi is the head is like this. Then it becomes like this, the widest part that I explained in the second point. Then you can still see the belly, and then it becomes narrow. That's not a good body posture. You want it to be straight, like a torpedo. So the fourth point that I want to discuss with you is the tail area. And the tail area is really, really important if you ask me. It determines like the growth rate, it gives a good indication in how fast a koi can grow and how big it will become. So it is important that a koi has a strong tail area. And this area, so I mean both the root and the last part of the tail, we call this the ozutsu. And the ozutsu area is, well, the tail area of course, and it is important that this area is broad. Like broad, like that. Not narrow, but broad. And that is also considered as the most important part of the tail, so it should be broad. But having said that, I think most people stare too much towards only the broadness of the tail. And I truly believe that you also have to take into account the height of the tail. So you want the tail as high as possible. And then I mean like this. You want it to be higher. So when you get a koi with a stronger body posture, also take that into account for sure. Not only broadness, but also the height of the tail. And that will really indicate the growth rate and the potential for a koi to grow bigger. So it is a key aspect as well. Then we will continue with the fifth point. And the fifth aspect is the pectoral fins. And the pectoral fins are, of course, these two front rays or big fins that it has. And what you want when you select any koi is that the fins are proportional with the rest of the body. So in proportion. And I prefer to have fins that are a little bit bigger than like the average size. Because I believe that when the fins are bigger, Then of course the koi can grow faster. Same as the tail, you want a big tail. So when you select a koi and you are taking body aspects into account, make sure that the two pectoral fins are large. But still it needs to be in proportion, of course. So not super big front fins, and then the rest of the body or the tail area really small. Everything in proportion. And also make sure that both fins have the same dimensions, because sometimes you can see that one fin, like the right one, is larger than the other one. So it needs to be in proportion and it needs to have the same size, but preferable a little bit bigger than average. Next item that I want to discuss is the head area. And for the head, it is important that to start with, it should of course be a quite broad head. You want a large head on a koi visible, in proportions of course with the rest of the body. Preferable the eyes on the head are wider, like quite width. But one aspect that I look for personally is also the triangle on the head area. So what I prefer is that you can make a super nice triangle between the nose and the two eyes. If you can put a triangle in between that, I believe that the proportions are good. So you don't want like that it is like this and then like this, that it is a really weird triangle. You want it to be in proportion. So a nice triangle, just like when you draw one on paper, that's what you want to see between the eyes and the tip of the nose. If that is the case, well, the base is at least correct. So that's good. Then when you look at the head, you also want a quite long head, preferable. A longer head area indicates at least a bigger head, stronger head, and also that indicates more growth. But one aspect that maybe a lot will forget about is that you should also look to the mouth. And why the mouth? Because the larger the mouth is, of course, the more it can eat. It needs to feed itself, and the more it eats, the bigger it can get. So you want a large mouth visible. And I think this chagoy, if you compare these two chagoys, you will see that this chagoy has a larger mouth. This one has a more like a pointy, sharper nose and sharper mouth, and also the mouth is less wide. So this chagoy regarding head is, in my opinion, better. But of course, opinions can be different. It is a large head, the eyes are width, you can make a perfect triangle. It's a long head, the mouth is really big. So actually, this chagoy has all the aspects that I prefer that it should have regarding the head area. Then overall, I also tend to look at how a koi swims. And of course, that is really difficult in a bowl. So you should look at it when it is swimming in like a pound before you net it. Like, is it swimming really elegant? Is it swimming with a strong pace? That's what I prefer personally. And also make sure that it is not hanging over to one side or leaning over to one side, of course. So it needs to have an elegant swim, not leaning over, and swimming in a straight line as well. Then overall, when you select a koi, take into account that body posture should be put on the first place. If you want a big koi, you really have to take body aspects into account. So the first thing you look for is the body proportions. The second thing is like skin quality, the glossiness of the skin, the intensity of the colors. And then on the last place, even though we often start looking at it first, is the pattern. So the last place is the pattern. First thing is body. And that's also what you can see in koi shows. Like, if you want high class koi, make sure that the body proportions are great and that the body is strong. The better the body, the higher the koi will be appreciated, also by Japanese judges, for example. So, and I hope this video gave you a lot of insights, and hopefully you can also use it during the selection of your own koi. And I hope you enjoyed the video, of course. Thank you for watching as well, and I hope to see you again in one of my next videos. Thank you for watching again, and consider to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you want to stay up to date with all new upcoming videos. Thanks for watching.